This is a film camera, and there's a chance that you don't even know what that is, depending on how old you are. I actually grew up shooting film a little bit when I was a lot younger. You know, digital came out in about the year 2000. This is a lot older than that. Basically trash, because it takes 127 film. It's really hard to get that now and even get it processed. But thanks to this free file over on Printables, we can actually swap this over to 35mm film and make it a lot more useful. The film is going to be cheaper, it's going to be easier to find, and it's going to be a lot easier to process. This camera was actually made between 1958 and 1965. It's such a cool little camera. I've always loved these, and I always really wanted to shoot them, but the film's never really been available. We do have to do a small modification to get this to work, but it's really not that bad. It's just removing a spring, basically, for the most part. It's actually really easy to remove these. It's this screw, and these two down here. You take those out and you're good to go. There's only three parts that you actually have to print for this to work. You have this little film gate that goes on the back. You also have these two little adapters that go onto the side of the film to make it fit as the same size as the 127 film. The best part about this is the fact that it only takes about 5 grams of filament and maybe about 20 minutes print over on my A1. Doing this is actually really easy. Now that we have the spring uninstalled, we can open up the back of the camera here. These aren't the easiest to get installed. The short does go on the longer side, and the bigger one goes on the one with the bigger hole. Trying to get this in can be a little bit of a pain. Going in like this has been better for me, but then we still need to get everything in right. Are we in? Guess we are in. Cool. From here, we can bring the film down, pull it out a bit, give it a little bend, twirl. Oh, that did the trick. Cool. This goes on here. We can close this up. We can reset the film counter by pressing this button. Resets it to 1. So now, if you found this video and you don't have a 3D printer, but you want to actually convert this over to 35mm film, you can use today's sponsor, PCBWay.
You can go directly over to their website, upload the files, and tell them how you want it printed. You know, I would recommend going with ABS, PETG, or PLA. It's super easy and it won't cost you a ton of money. Thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video.
There is a back window here. You want to make sure that this is closed at all times because this is a straight view into the camera where the film is at. Technically, you're seeing that back plate, but it still can let light in on 127 or 120 film. There's a paper backing that actually has numbers on it to kind of give you how many exposures you've gone through and how many shots you've actually done. On regular 35mm film, you don't have that. Now, starting at the top, you can see where it's exposed from where we loaded it up. I did not do a very good job of actually cranking this thing properly. I actually have a couple images that overlap here, a couple that overlap here. As you can see, we're starting to see more space between each shot. This is also just me not realizing how much I'm cranking, but after this part, we're missing a whole bunch of potential shots that we could have used. In total, I only got 19, including the ones that overlap, which isn't bad, but it's definitely not 36 shots. Now, it's kind of cool to see the image take up the whole film, including the sprocket holes. It just, with the sprocket holes in there and seeing everything exposed, it's just a really cool look, and I do really like that. It's really cool when you use slide film like that because you get all the poppy colors while you're just looking at the negative itself. Overall, using this free modification from Printables has been really cool. It does make the camera usable again, which I think is really nice. It kind of saves it from the landfill. It doesn't get tossed into the trash because, you know, you can't use it anymore. Shooting with these style of camera is always fun just because you have your viewfinder up here and you're kind of looking like this and you have to focus using this knob. Overall, it's just super cool. It's just a really cool experience to shoot something like this, and it's even doubly so when you get to save a camera from, you know, otherwise being in the landfill. Let me know what you think about this. I know this video is probably not going to be for everybody. I just really wanted to showcase the fact that you can use 3D printing to revive an old camera that would have otherwise found the trash can. Well, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you hit that like button and consider subscribing to the channel if you want to see more great content. This is Adam from the Rad Dad Print Lab, but before you go, you should definitely check out this video right here because you know what? YouTube thinks you'll like it. See ya.